Also signed a measure to help renters and gave an update on where things stand with nursing homes. Channel 3 Eyewitness News Chief Capitol Reporter Susan Raff is live now with the very latest on the relief effort. Susan.
Dennis, renters have pretty much been left out of the relief picture, so this latest executive order could give them some protection. As for nursing homes, the state is now working to staff those that would specifically deal with those who are infected. In the meantime, with all of these executive orders, some lawmakers are raising concerns about the governor exercising too much power.
There's a group that we were left leaving out, and folks that in those areas that are predominantly renters, what can we do for them?
Relief for renters. A new order being signed by Governor Lamont says there can be no evictions before July 1st. When it comes to April's rent, there is a 60-day grace period. As for May's rent, tenants can get another 60 days, but they must make a request to their landlord explaining their situation on how they have been financially impacted by the coronavirus. Another focus is on nursing homes. Many of the nursing homes in Connecticut have residents who are infected. The plan is to have specific homes to treat only those who have COVID-19. The Department of Public Health tells us they are working on staffing and medical supplies. If approved, this facility in Meriden could be a coronavirus recovery facility. The governor has signed numerous executive orders, and on Thursday, he extended the shutdown of schools and many businesses until May 20th. Republican leaders feel they've been left out. In a letter to the governor, Senator Len Fasano says, "Your authority has become more broad and your strategy less collaborative. Your latest executive order does not reflect any collaboration with legislative leaders." But House Majority Leader Matt Ritter says his issue is not the executive orders. He says, "We should not be so focused on the dates. Instead, we should pick the metrics as a way to give the public a sense of when we can reopen."
For me, the number one metric is hospitalization. That seems to be a template for what's going on more broadly in terms of infections throughout the community. And secondly, a real testing regimen to make sure that people are safe when they get back to work.
Representative Ritter did tell us today that on daily conference calls with the governor, Republicans and Democrats have been talking to the governor on a daily basis. One of the things that he feels, however, that needs to be addressed when businesses reopen, that we look at things like limiting capacity. And maybe an idea would be that employers may want to start taking temperatures of their employees. Susan Raff, Channel 3, Eyewitness News.
Okay.